Yes, children, after the poem recitation, let us go through the line-to-line explanation of the poem and even the introduction of the poetess, Charlotte Bronte. Unit 1, 1.1, Life by Charlotte Bronte. About the author, Charlotte Bronte was an English novelist and poetess. Born to a clergyman, she had to bear the loss of her mother at the age of 5. All her siblings were keen young writers. The family lived for a long time in Haworth. She was a governess and then an English teacher. As an author, she used a pen name Currer Bell. Her best-known work includes Jane Eyre. Now let us see the warming up activity. There are many popular lines like "Life is a game, play it well." Life is a journey, keep going ahead. Now children, all these are metaphorical lines. Now we are going to discuss and write down a few such metaphorical lines about life. You can make them up yourselves. Children, this is an activity for you to do it at home in this lockdown period. You are going to use such kind of metaphorical lines using your own imagination and create. Second one is prepare as many acrostics using the word life as you can. Two examples are given below. Life, L-I-F-E, live in freedom ever. Liberty, integrity, fraternity and equality. Now children, you can turn it into a game using a time limit. Make sure your acrostics are related to life. Now, listen carefully and write the word in the appropriate column. In positive and negative feelings, over here, few words are listed below. Now, what you need to do, you have to write them in the perfect column. For example, positive feelings include hopeful, happy, surprised, loving, cheerful, excited, comfortable, peaceful, enthusiastic, motivated, inspired. Negative feelings are lonely, jealous, proud, anxious, nervous, embarrassed, scared, silly, depressed, threatened, and angry. Now note that it is possible to feel both kinds of emotions at the same time. Have you experienced it? Try to describe the situation in short in your English notebook. Open the textbook where life poem is written, page number 3. Life, believe, is not a dream so dark as sages say. Over here, the poetess wonderfully describes that life is a dream, but it is not that dark dream as sages say. Sages means wise men. Many wise men say that it is a dark dream, but according to the poetess, it's not a dark dream. Oft a little morning rain. Oft a little. Oft means archaic word that is used over here. Oft means often. Oft a little morning rain foretells a pleasant day. At times in our life, we have certain problems or difficult situations in our life. So instead of just having a grief over it, instead of lamenting over it, why not find the solutions of a little morning rain? It tells. What does it tell? Foretells a pleasant day. That means after bad times, good times will always follow suit. Foretells here means predicts. It predicts that good times, good situations in our life are going to come. Pleasant, it means enjoyable. The day later on will be enjoyable. So we don't have to lament over it. We don't have to express our grief just because if it rains in the morning. Sometimes there are clouds of gloom. Sometimes there are clouds of gloom here. The poetess beautifully expresses that clouds of gloom, that is depression or dejection, that is there at times in our life just due to difficult situations, they even pass quickly because they are not permanent. But these are transient all. Transient means temporary. As bad times are temporary, similarly, after that, good times are going to follow. Because they are all temporary phases in our life. Good times and bad times, they keep on coming in our life. If the shower will make the roses bloom, naturally, whenever there is showers, we are going to see greenery, we are going to see colorful atmosphere around. So if this is then why should we lament? Why should we express our grief or show regret? Rapidly, merrily, life's sunny hours fled by. Rapidly means quickly. Merrily means happily. Happily, quickly, life's sunny hours. Sunny hours means the joyful moments of our life pass on in a jiffy. Very quickly, they flit by. They pass quickly. So, what we have to do? We have to enjoy those moments. Children, as we all know that we enjoyed our session 2020-19 nicely. But suddenly, there was a bad times. What kind of bad time? We nowadays we are facing COVID-19. So what do we come to know? That these bad times, these difficult situations in our life, they are also going to pass, as good times also pass quickly. So what do we have to do? We need to cherish all kind of good memories in our life and enjoy each and every moment at present, joyfully, gratefully, cheerily, enjoy them as they fly. Enjoy them as they fly. The time that is flying, that is being utilized, the present time should be enjoyed nicely, happily, so that we can cherish those experiences in our life. Why? Because it says, what though death at times steps in and calls our best away. This COVID-19 situation is the best example where in the whole world, in some or the other country, some or the other state, district, our own area or somewhere, what do we find? We find that death, it embraces people, families, just because of COVID-19 or due to some or the other reason, our near and dear ones are taken away from us, never to be seen again. That's why, children, that particular moment when they are with us, we should enjoy it happily and cherish those moments. What though sorrow seems to win? At times it happens. Good times and bad times when they come by and by. So naturally, what though sorrow seems to win over hope a heavy sway? So those moments when we have all kind of difficult situations in our life, those moments are taken away. Okay. And we at times try to lose hope, but again there is a challenge in our life. Here sway means controlling influence. Yet hope again elastic springs, unconquered though she fell, still buoyant are her golden wings, still strong to bear us well. The last paragraph talks of hope seemingly being overpowered by sorrow due to the loss of a dear one. In this paragraph, the poetess continues saying that even though hope may seem to be fallen, but she remains undefeated. She bounces back like an elastic spring. Hope is personified and is said to have the metaphorical buoyant golden wings that are full of strength to hold us and carry us upwards above the sorrows. Manfully, fearlessly, the day of trial bear, for gloriously, victoriously can courage quell despair. Before I explain these lines, I would like to say, in the stanza, the poet explained that even in difficult situations, a ray of hope keeps us moving ahead in life. For example, a sports person faces good and bad times in his career. The poetess then compares hope with a bird having golden wings that help her to rise upwards as they are strong to face challenges of life. In the last four lines, the poetess urges the reader to courageously face the challenges, difficulties and problems of life. The last line conveys a message that courage can end all misery and remove all darkness from our life. Children, try to answer the questions given on page number 3 and complete the English workshop given on page number 4. In our next video, we will be discussing the answers related to these questions and workshop answers. Thank you.